Thank you. Good morning. My name is Tim Curley, and I serve as Chair of the Board of Trustees of Claremont Graduate University. On behalf of the board, it is my pleasure to welcome you to CGU's 95th Annual Commencement. So if everyone would please stand, and I will call upon one of the chaplains of the Claremont Colleges, Reverend Dr. Naima Lett, to deliver this year's invocation. Dr. Lett.
Would you pray with me? Gracious God, thank you for enabling us to gather together today to celebrate and to honor these graduates of Claremont Graduate University. Thank you for all of the accomplishments that led to this day and for the completions that have taken place. Thank you so much for the dreams come true and for what's ahead. We pray blessings upon all of our family and friends that have traveled near and far to be with us for this occasion. And we also say thank you so much for the administration and the faculty and staff, the alumni, and all of the supporters. On this day, we pray for new beginnings as we start this commencement. New beginnings, new opportunities, new open doors, and most of all, for joy and peace and celebration. As Protestant chaplain, I pray in the name of Jesus, but I invite you to close this blessing in the way that you seem most comfortable. And we all say, amen.
Thank you, Reverend Dr. Lett. I would now ask our guests to please be seated. And it is my pleasure to introduce the president of Claremont Graduate University, Lynn Jessup, who will conduct our graduation ceremony.
Thank you, Tim. Well, good morning. We're finally here. Tim and I got to celebrate our first commencement together in person in 2019, and we were, as you are, so looking forward to being able to do this one in person as well. So on behalf of the Board of Trustees, Tim and all of our trustees here, and our faculty and staff and students here at Claremont Graduate University, it's my sincere pleasure to welcome you to the 95th commencement. We've got three important groups of candidates today, not just one graduating class, but three, the graduating class of 2022 and members of 2020 and 2021. Congratulations. As I said, the last time we did this in person was 2019. The tent was a little smaller then. We've kind of grown. And obviously, the pandemic has drastically changed our lives. Graduate school is hard enough, right? And then to put a global health crisis on top of it and everything else that's happened the last couple of years. Needless to say, it's an unprecedented time for our graduates and for everyone. The keys to success for our students have been around perseverance and determination and patience and resilience. And graduates, you've all demonstrated that. And so today we celebrate your accomplishments. And what a great group of graduates we've got. Diverse, incredibly talented, incredibly smart, hardworking group of graduates. I'm so proud to be here celebrating with you today. Some of you came straight to us through your undergraduate school, and some had to put their graduate dreams on hold to raise families. Others have traveled very far from home, along with their families, or had to leave their families left behind in home countries. Let me just tell you a couple quick things about this graduating class you might not know. Our youngest graduate and our oldest graduate this year. This will be a guessing game. So our youngest graduate this year across the three classes, so think about it, try to come up with an age in your mind. They gotta get through undergraduate in at least a year or two and a master's program. You can kind of come up with what you think the age might be. But this season, our youngest graduate is 21 years old. That That had to be hard to do, to get through everything that quickly. Even more impressive, our oldest graduate, think of a number, share it with your person sitting next to you. Our oldest graduate this year is 72 years old. I'm a little closer to 72 than 21. I want all of them to know, and especially our oldest grad, how grateful I am that all of you chose your graduate school journey with CGU and that you're all part of the CGU family now. So my two messages to the class of 2022, you've faced many challenges because you've faced the tail end of our lockdowns and then getting, you know, being allowed to come back to campus. It was a difficult year, and it took a lot of resilience from people to get through all of that and the changes that we had to make. And you represent, I think, the power and the potential of intellect and passion and discipline with flexibility and creativity to get through the experience and now to advance knowledge and in the CGU way to go out and actually have an impact and improve the world. Congratulations to our recent grads, this 2022 grads, on taking that journey with us and that journey that brought you here today. Well done. Congratulations, 2022. And to the members of the prior two classes of 2020 and 2021, thank you for your patience as you went through a virtual ceremony. We were doing the best we could. We all waited to bring you back today. I'm so glad that you've decided to come back and experience it in person with us. You've succeeded in the face of many challenges as well. We weren't able to honor the way that you deserved at the time, but we're so glad we're able to do it today. And we welcome you here today and thank you for your patience and congratulations on your accomplishments. 2020 and 2021, way to go. Okay, before we begin, let me just acknowledge who's sitting here behind me. The platform party today includes many CGU trustees in addition to Tim. We've got many of our deans and directors of programs, schools, centers, institutes. We've got several faculty, several administrators, VPs from our executive council, and they've all helped to create the outstanding graduate research and learning environment that you got to experience the past few years. So let's give a round of applause to thank them for everything they do for CGU. And then deviating a little bit from script, but I want to call attention to one person in particular who doesn't know I'm going to do this, but we have faculty marshals who shepherd everyone in and out and kind of take care of the crowds here up on the platform. And one in particular, Marshal Kathy Pezdek, she's behind me somewhere, if she would raise her hand. She's a professor in psych in the Division of Behavioral and Organizational Sciences. Kathy let me know that she has been a marshal at every single commencement here since 1982. That's quite a run. Kathy, thank you. And finally, I want to recognize my seatmate, Dr. Richard Carmona, former Surgeon General of the United States. His life has been an inspiration to us all. He's a friend from my days in Tucson, and he's an example of the CGU way and taking what you know and putting it into practice to make the world a better place. I'll give a longer introduction for Dr. Carmona, but welcome, Rich. It's so good to have you here. All right, let's get going. Here we go. We're going to begin with something very special that we do that I don't know of any other university that does this. But as we get underway, we're going to start with a very special award. And it's so special, in fact, that the winner does not know that this is happening. 22 years ago, Pamela Mullen and her children created the Pamela M. Mullen Dream and Believe Award. Dream and Believe. And for many years, Ms. Mullen was an inspiring member of our Board of Trustees and was on the platform here for many graduations. This award gives a very generous stipend to a continuing doctoral student that basically enables them to continue pursuing their dream and finishing their work up and not having to worry about finances, and then to just focus on having a positive impact in the world. I want to acknowledge some of the members of the Mullen family and their spouses who have helped with the award throughout the years. Brian and Kelly, Darcy and Matt, Tim and Rebecca. They couldn't be with us, but they are watching on the live stream today. Even there's a couple of monitors around, you may see them pop up. I want to thank them for supporting an award that has changed so many students' lives so dramatically for so many years. And we also, I want to say that this past year, we mourned the passing of Pamela Mullen, but her spirit clearly lives on here at CGU with this award and her impact. And so it's my pleasure to introduce Professor Ali Nadim, from the director of our Institute of Mathematical Sciences, and he will announce the recipient of this year's award. The student doesn't know this is going to happen, but Ali, would you come forward?
Thank you, President Jessup. The Pamela M. Mullen Dream and Believe Award was inspired by the life and spirit of Ms. Mullen. I want to call everyone's attention to the Zoom screen. This year's winner thinks he is on Zoom to help us recognize his faculty advisor as part of this ceremony. He is not. We had to trick him because Ms. Mullen wanted this award to be a surprise. Now, it is my great honor to present the first student ever from our Institute of Mathematical Sciences to win this award. Please join me in congratulating doctoral student Danielle Akesh as the recipient of the 2022 Pamela M. Mullen Dream and Believe Award. Danielle, because you cannot be here in person today, I would like to read from the citation prepared in your honor. This citation will help everyone understand why you were chosen as this year's recipient. The citation reads, Danielle Akesh, in recognition of your extraordinary determination, courage, and spirit that enabled you to overcome war and displacement as one of Sudan's lost boys, and to seek a new life in the United States. Your many outstanding academic achievements, from the sweltering classrooms of a refugee camp in Kenya to the Institute of Mathematical Sciences at Claremont Graduate University. Your powerful recognition that without parents to guide you, education would become your parent and the pursuit of high achieving academic excellence would be your North Star. Your dream of helping other refugees by creating the Walking Buildings Scholarship Program. Claremont Graduate University is pleased and honored to present you with the 2022 Pamela M. Mullen Dream and Believe Award, an award recognizing that dreams, in addition to learning, knowledge, and wisdom, truly matter. Congratulations, Daniel. We are so proud of you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Nadim. I was prepared to thank my advisor, but I'm just blown away by this.
Daniel, we're so proud of you. I hope you can hear me. Was it a surprise? Were we able to keep it a secret?
I was surprised. I was getting ready to thank my advisor, which I will still want to do. but I'm blown away. I'm sitting here with my family in Nakuru. And this is really amazing. I cannot thank the CGU enough for this opportunity. And we are all grateful here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Daniel. Congratulations. And thanks to the Mullen family. They're on the live stream. Thank you so much for allowing us to participate in this wonderful experience each year. All right, moving on. It is now my pleasure to introduce this year's commencement speaker. Everyone's getting an alert. There's a fire up in one of the canyons, I believe, by Glendale. I believe that's what it is. Somebody give me a nod. I think that's, yeah, no imminent danger here. Okay. All right, I'll give you a moment to silence the alert. Thank you. Dr. Richard H. Carmona, since this crisis began, we've all been thinking about public health. We've all become experts in epidemiology. It's a topic on everyone's mind. But Dr. Carmona's interest in public health is real. It didn't just start with the pandemic. It's a fight that he's been fighting all his life, and especially from the medical part of his career, fighting against health disparities. He's been an important advocate in that area. And he's a true American success story, right? From his roots, coming into the country, then born and raised in New York City, his family struggled to make ends meet. He then found a way out through military service, like many do, a decorated Army Special Forces veteran, and then got himself into medical school and became a pioneer in medical innovation and leadership. And in 2002, he was unanimously confirmed by the U.S. Senate as the 17th Surgeon General of the United States. Dr. Carmona has devoted his tenure as Surgeon General to advocating for health access, for proactive health strategies, and for health literacy. And in addition, Dr. Carmona has held positions in academia and in senior leadership, including directorships of several public and private boards, and influencing the world in that way, and especially in the health field, the CEO of a hospital in the healthcare system, and then more recently, vice chair of Canyon Ranch and president of the Canyon Ranch Institute, Center for Health and Well-Being in Tucson that's now has a worldwide footprint. We're so honored to have him here with us today. It's so good for me to see Rich personally again. Graduates, family, friends, and other guests, it gives me great pleasure to welcome this year's commencement speaker, Dr. Richard Carmona.
Good morning, and my profound gratitude and appreciation to President Len Jessup and the faculty and students of GCU for the privilege to be with you today to hopefully deliver a short inspirational message within the troubled world that is in desperate need of well-informed, nonpartisan, selfless leadership like all of you, that is prepared to go forth, fueled by your diverse talents, ethnicities, and genders, in order to salvage our 250-year-old experiment of democracy and appreciate integrative well-being and human flourishing for all, the thematic message of this convocation. We are at another critical juncture in the history of our nation. Two questionable wars burdening us over more than 20 years. Some of you have never witnessed peace in your lifetime. We have been threatened by climate change, social and health inequities, an ever-increasing epidemic of gun violence, the global rise of autocracies, and the internal and external undermining of democracy. As if the aforementioned were not enough, we overlaid the first pandemic in over a century, COVID, which became the great divider, uniter, and accelerator. We appeared not as the United States, but rather the disunited States. But we did unite globally to crowdsource the best science in the world in an attempt to prevent, respond to, mitigate, and recover from COVID. And also, let us not forget a simultaneous attempted insurrection that was blatantly, visually evident to all, but casually dismissed by some, including elected officials whose behavior was characterized by some as seditious. The aforementioned all being further fueled by hyperpartisan, toxic, malignant politics, further driven by an epidemic of constant misinformation, digitally accelerated, and itself gone viral, with no known mitigating factors and no vaccine possible for this cultural viral pathogen, which has potentiated the aforementioned challenges and exposed our nation's societal vulnerabilities, from our struggling public health infrastructure to the social determinants of health, human capital, supply chain issues, the environment, and even redefining essential employees. For example, the poor migrant workers who toil selflessly for less than minimum wage along our southern borders in farms and ranches, who were rapidly elevated to essential employees when it was evident that America will not eat unless they are healthy and work. In all of the aforementioned challenges, the public yearns for leadership, simply stated from those who are elected and entrusted with our destiny. Unfortunately, more times than not, the public is disappointed, for the void and selfless leadership is glaring. I'm sad that we failed to come together, not as politicians, but as Americans under one nation, to address all these threats. Instead, a partisan chasm divided us further and afforded our enemies opportunities to capitalize on our weaknesses. However, I am elated to have the privilege to address you on this joyous, well-earned day. Although clouded by numerous threats to our nation's health, safety, and security, and all of us being bound together by our founding fathers who entrusted us with subsequent generations with their intellectual property, our Constitution, that provided us an ever-evolving azimuth to freedom that is ours to lose unless we protect it wisely. In order to achieve the elegant Claremont Graduate University aspiration of integrated well-being and human flourishing, we must take action. For the only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is that good men, and I would add women, do nothing. This quote, uncertain derivation, claimed by many but with no clear author, is self-evident today more than ever. I could just wax and wane about your accomplishments, great intellect, and brilliant futures. Or I can do what a Surgeon General does traditionally in response to national or global threats, issue a call to action. So today, 467 graduate degrees in much-needed diverse fields will be awarded. No longer can any of us pontificate and hope for a better tomorrow, for hope is not a strategy, and urgency permeates every breath we take, necessitating nonpartisan, well-informed, innovative, and market-disruptive solutions to restore and create remedies to perpetuate not only our democracy, but create a healthy, safe, and free world. CGU has prepared you all very well to rise to the leadership and pursue the perfect union our forefathers envisioned, as well as being that global beacon of hope for many struggling in a COVID-exhausted and inequitable world. To do so, some points to consider. Embrace leadership, for irrespective of the scope or scale, leaders are responsible for the destiny of others. Find mentors with integrity to guide you. Commit to selfless service to include providing sometimes inconvenient truth to elected officials while holding them accountable. Live your life driven by purpose and a sense of urgency. Do not fear honest failure, but take calculated risks. Your character is your most important currency, complemented by competence and compassion. Always choose the harder right instead of the easy wrong. Remember, diverse groups are more innovative and productive than homogeneous groups. Continue to renew yourself throughout your life. Maintain your relevance. Your legacy is the effectiveness of your organization after you leave. In closing, I humbly and passionately present these concepts and call to action to you all, for you are CGU's gift to a nation and world in turbulence, a force multiplier for peace, prosperity, equality, and a safer, more secure world. As for me, the high school dropout, oldest son of Spanish-speaking immigrant parents, I have had the privilege to serve my community and nation in uniform in peace and combat for over half my life. I have far exceeded my mother's aspiration and expectations because all she wanted to do was go to a graduation, and she only meant high school because nobody in the family had ever graduated from high school. Therefore, you see that I am personally committed because I have reaped the immense benefits of our nation and what it has to offer. I want to ensure that our democracy is repaired, strengthened, and perpetuated in order to achieve the CGU value proposition of integrative well-being and human flourishing, while once again having our nation be seen as the beacon of hope for all global masses still struggling in a COVID-exhausted world. Thank you.
Wow, thank you, Rich. Your life and your words have been so inspiring to us. Thanks for being here today. Thanks for making the world a better place. Once again, yeah, thank you, Rich. Great job. All right. Stirring words. Now, next, our student speaker, and I'm going to introduce the person who's going to introduce the student speaker. So I want to take a moment to thank our Graduate Student Council officers, President Arlene Vortruba, Vice President Christina Kalias, Treasurer Francis Asenga, and the Secretary Holly Eva Allen, and then all of the extended officers of the GSC Executive Board. Thank you all for your service this academic year. It's been a challenging year. You've all risen to the challenge, and it's been great working with you all this year. So one of those members will be introducing our speaker. Christine Kalias will introduce our student speaker for today. In addition to serving as GSC Vice President, Christina is in the English doctoral program, and she's pursuing an early modern studies concentration. And she's also a practicing scholar. Her work has been presented at many major conferences hosted by the Shakespeare Association of America and other prestigious organizations. And did you know that Shakespeare talked about the importance of scholarship in his work? It had an academic tilt. I'm sure Christina knows that, and her work does as well. Shakespeare once wrote that study is like heaven's glorious sun. Study is like heaven's glorious sun. Sounds a lot like a motto that I know quite well. Well, that glorious sun keeps shining here at CGU thanks to the outstanding work of scholars like Christina. So please join me in welcoming Christina, who will introduce our student speaker. Christina?
Thank you, President Jessup. Good morning, everyone. Today, I have the honor of introducing our 2022 student commencement speaker this year, Jason Beck. For Jason, one of the most important qualities that any leader needs is mindfulness. Of course, that is not the only quality that a good leader needs. When you think of a good leader, you think of someone who can think strategically, delegate to others, has a vision, and many other qualities found in most books about leadership. But for Jason, being mindful is the key to all of these other qualities. Being mindful is the ground from which everything else grows. Last fall, Jason successfully defended his PhD in positive organizational psychology. Even though being a doctoral student is quite demanding, Jason has not just focused on academics alone. Jason has been very active in many parts of grad student life. He has been a teaching assistant, a podcast host, an organizer of the Lab Olympics competition that DBOS holds every year, and so much else. All of these activities have added to his own sense of self, to Jason's own understanding of what mindfulness is. Now, thanks to his training and experiences, Jason is proud to call himself an organizational consultant, a professor, a researcher, and of course, a great leader. We have asked him to share his perspective on what this big day means for all of our graduates. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming our 2022 student speaker, Jason Beck.
Thank you, Christina, for the introduction. Greetings. Thank you, distinguished faculty, administrators, trustees, family, friends, and congratulations to Claremont Graduate University's graduating class. To begin, let me present a story, a thought experiment. You are walking on campus here along 10th Street on the sidewalk across from the library going towards Dartmouth Street. And you see a piece of trash on the sidewalk, a king-size candy bar wrapper. Whose responsibility is to pick up that piece of trash and throw it away? Do you pick it up and throw it away? Or do you walk right past it, blissfully ignoring the trash? We can all agree that picking up trash is a good thing, but why? See, I'm perplexed by this because I came to CGU wanting to learn how to make the world happier. Although a projection of my own selfish desire to be happier myself, it is a noble cause to want to leave the world better than how we found it. And in my naive eyes, happier is better. Many of you might have had a similar motivation on your first day at CGU. I came here to become happier and to help make the world happier. But deep down, what I was in search of was not happiness. I was in search of meaning. Fast forward through the shared struggles of back-to-back exams, sleepless nights studying, completing a degree in a pandemic, we made it here to commencement. Did we become happier? Can we make the world happier? Is happiness actually the goal in human flourishing? I'll present quite a surprising idea. To spread human flourishing, what the world needs most is not to be happier, but the willingness to take on responsibility to make the world better. We must choose to pick up the piece of trash on the sidewalk, not because it is inherently a happy thing to do to pick up trash, but rather because taking on responsibility, even in such a small manner, bonds us to something bigger than who we are. This leads to a meaningful life, and meaning is better than happy. In my own research, I soon learned that happiness is not necessarily the only best goal. Happiness is fleeting. Our brains can't really be happy all of the time. Sadness is okay. Frustration is okay. Stress is more than okay. It's quite literally necessary for us to perform at our best. It bonds a group of students together to become more than colleagues, friends. Friends in a shared conquest to pass the introductory stats class sequence. When we voluntarily look at the difficult things in our lives, we can manage them better. Steps to fixing a difficult relationship at work or at home is not to just become happier. No, the better strategy is to muster the courage to have a transformative conversation. That is what CGU's first president, James Blaisdell, etched in the concrete pillars on campus. The center of a great college is great conversation. Not happy conversation, great conversation. One in which the willing intention is to challenge each other's assumptions, sharpen each other's morality, and take on responsibility to do good. That is where the meaningful life harbors. That is at the heart of CGU's discourse. That is human flourishing. Happiness is a lucky byproduct of the deliberate path of confronting challenge and doing something about it. The worthwhile endeavor is not how can I create more happiness, instead how can I create more meaning. Our graduate education enables us to extend responsibilities to the world, not run away from them. This sentiment is emphasized in CGU's motto, Multa Lumina Lux Una, many flames, one light. And today, we celebrate a shared alliance to bring one light to a world of darkness. We are beacons of hope in hard times. That is the gift of our education. That is the gift of CGU. May we go forward into the darkness and be light for others. May we be able to carry the flames of hope to a world so in need of strength. May we create flourishing, mighty, meaningful lives of helping others. May we pick up that piece of trash. Congratulations, graduating class of 2020, 21, 22. Thank you so much.
Jason, that was terrific. Congratulations. Let's give him another round of applause. Well done. All right, this morning we will confer honorary degrees to two individuals whose achievements have inspired us. That's always a very special moment in the commencement ceremony, and today I think it's even more special. You'll see in a moment. These individuals will receive the degree Doctor of Science, honoris causa, in recognition of their significant and lasting accomplishments. And to present this year's recipients, I call on Professor Gary Gaukler, Chair of the Faculty. Gary?
Thank you, Len. By vote of the faculty of Claremont Graduate University and with the approval of the Board of Trustees, I am pleased to present Dr. Richard H. Carmona and Marshall Vallelunga for the degree Doctor of Science, honoris causa.
Thank you, Professor Gochler. Yes? We'll now recognize each of these candidates individually. So Board Chair Tim Curley and Provost Patricia Easton will assist. And if they would please come forward. Will our first candidate, Dr. Richard Carmona, please step forward for conferral of the honorary degree?
Dr. Richard H. Carmona, you have devoted your remarkably varied career to the promotion of health success and access and literacy across the nation and the world. You have vigorously addressed the disparities confronting so many citizens. As the 17th Surgeon General of the United States, you focused on prevention, preparedness, health disparities, health literacy, and global health, and issued many landmark communications. As the embodiment of the American dream, you inspire us with your personal story of overcoming an impoverished early life in New York City and rising to assume the top health advocacy position in our nation. As a steadfast believer in public service, you are a combat-decorated veteran of the U.S. Army's Special Forces in Vietnam and a former highly decorated member of Tucson's Pima County Sheriff's Department, serving as a deputy sheriff, detective, SWAT team leader, and department surgeon. As a pioneer in medical innovation and leadership, you founded the first regional trauma care system for the Tucson Medical Center in Arizona and the University of Arizona, and you served as the CEO of the Pima County Hospital and Healthcare System. As a steward of the public good, you have held numerous senior leadership positions with several public and private boards. Dr. Richard H. Carmona, because of your tireless advocacy to ensure that health access and education are essential rights of every person, because of your extensive efforts and publication in support of these rights, and because of your involvement with many companies today to identify technologies and science that can achieve social good and economic benefit, upon the recommendation of the faculty and with approval of the Board of Trustees of Claremont Graduate University, we confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Science honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereunto.
Okay, I didn't think that was the one I was going to get emotional about. We've got a very special honorary degree to recognize posthumously. I'd like to call on Professor Terry Ryan to help with that. And he's the interim director of the Center for Information Systems and Technology. So Terry, would you please make your way down? Marshall Vallelonga was a member of our Center of Information Systems and Technology, our CISAT community. And he is the posthumous recipient of a Master's of Science in Information Systems and Technology, which will be awarded later. He worked very closely with Terry and other faculty in CISAT. Accepting the degree today will be Nina, his wife. Before Nina comes up, I'd like to say a few words about Marshall. He touched the lives of many here tragically in a tragic accident over the holidays back in December, January, lost his life. He had a deep love for teaching, strong bond with students. I understand from Terry and others that all he had left was a dissertation, and he was so busy helping other students with their dissertations, he wasn't spending time on his own. In his early college days, he worked on the SR-71 Blackbird by stress testing the plane's wings in a top secret facility. Marshall later joined the National Guard and served as an officer for 10 years. And when Marshall enrolled in CGU's PhD program, as I said, he gave generously to his peers. He was helping others, even sometimes when it delayed his own progress. He supported them, and that left him with less time to work on his dissertation, practically speaking. A master's degree is technically the degree that Marshall has earned, given the classes that he took here, but it's clear that the doctoral degree is really what he deserved. So today, in recognition of his service to the country and to Claremont Graduate University, and in light of his many accomplishments, we are recognizing Marshall, not only with his master's degree, but with an honorary doctorate. So Nina, would you please come forward? Thank you.
Nina, on behalf of the president, myself, and everyone at Claremont Graduate University, it gives me great pleasure to confer upon Marshall Valenzuela the degree of Doctor of Science honoris causa in recognition of his hard work and commitment to others. Congratulations.
Nina, thanks. And Terry, thank you. All right. This is a special place. We now come to the time when we celebrate today's candidates who have completed their courses of study and other requirements to receive their degrees. To all of you graduating, I offer my sincere congratulations. And to award the degrees you've earned, we shall proceed in the following way. First, we'll present candidates for the degrees as a group, and then we'll confer doctoral and master's degrees individually. We'll ask each graduate to come forward to the stage and the second part to be recognized individually. And so to begin, may I ask Provost Easton to present the candidates for the various degrees.
Good morning. Will the candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy, the Doctor of Musical Arts, and the Doctor of Public Health please rise and remain standing? Mr. President, I present the candidates for the doctoral degree, the highest earned degree of Claremont Graduate University.
Thank you, Patricia. By granting you this degree, the university signifies its confidence that you've made an original and important contribution to human knowledge, and that you'll continue a life of scholarship in a way that benefits humankind. And upon the recommendation of the faculty and with the approval of the Board of Trustees of Claremont Graduate University, it is my privilege to now confer upon each of you the doctoral degree with all its rights and privileges pertaining thereto, and to welcome you to the ancient and venerable community of scholars and to the CGU family. Congratulations to all of you.
Will the candidates for the doctoral degree please be seated until we call you to come forward to be recognized individually. Will the candidates for master's degrees please rise and remain standing? Mr. President, I present our candidates for master's degrees.
Thank you, Patricia. On the recommendation of the faculty and with the approval of the Board of Trustees of Claremont Graduate University, it is my privilege to confer upon each of you now the appropriate master's degree with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations to you all. Well done.
Will the candidates for the master's degrees please be seated until we call you to come forward to be recognized individually. At this time, we honor our individual degree recipients, and this year is special. Our group of recipients is much larger than in years past. It is our pleasure today to have the class of 2022 joined by members of the classes of 20 and 21. Will the faculty from the Drucker School please come down to the front stage to be prepared to hood your doctoral students as they approach the podium? As the marshal directs, will the candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Public Health, Doctor of Philosophy, and Doctor of Musical Arts also come forward to be recognized individually? These are the graduates of the Drucker School of Graduate School of Management. Sorry for the feedback. Rodney Wilson. Robert Reich. Will the faculty of the Drucker School please be seated, and the faculty from the Community and Global Health please come forward. Mafualaki Ajiliani. Alyssa Nicole Kalunga. Davina Arias. Jake Ryan C. Sumbake. Bree Hemingway. Juanita Preciado. Ali Mazuar Heliloqui. Emily Joy Karush. Ame Vikrama Singh. Skylar Lauren Hansen. Gola Song. Nursila Chan. Nathan Makul Kamal. Brittany Christina Lytel. Cindy Delgado. Amanda Adele Mitri. Undefreke Etem. Will the Faculty of Community and Global Health please be seated? And will the faculty for the Center for Information Systems and Technology please come forward? Konstantinos Papatanio. Sarah Ackworthy. Balakrishnan Nair Mula Cherry. Joseph Kimani Bogwa. Claudia Felissa Casera. Sarah Alismal. Sarah Oselan. Hengwei Jiang. Alan Mugambe Gaitubu. May the Faculty of Information Systems please be seated. And may the Faculty for the Division of Behavioral and Organizational Sciences please come forward. Teraput Pitisha. Caleb H. Mitchell. Garen E. Gaskin. I was just like, Cleopatra Marcia Tellis. Sierra C. Knight. Agnieszka Maria Elena Regaleska. Fun Kung Pham. Heather Dawn Codd. Lawrence Brandon Chan. Alana D'Antona. Jason Beck. Jared Kyle Chapman. Megan Ann Smith. Eunice Unbi Choi. Ching-Hui Chang. Thank you. Jeff Varun Ramdas. Sarah Michelle Holler. Susanna Marianne Bonus. Will my colleagues in DBOS please be seated? And will the faculty in politics and economics please come forward? Carlos Alberto Echeverra Estrada. Min-Jae Yoon. Morgan Elaine Stockham. Yuni Mei Lee. Paige Richmond. Lena Press Urai. Jayan G. Rao. Just look, it's written. Zaid Abdulhadi El-Kadidi. Thank you. Zoha Haman. Rana Suleiman Alugali. Zimbo Hu. Simon H. Tang. Joseph Imormimo. Glenn Ian Steinbeck. Aaron Berg. Victor Haynes. Jerry Taylor Fink. Dongwoo Kim. Jiaqiao Ji. Wenjie Zhang. Madeline Jung Young Su. Miriam Sierra Aguilar. Nanbiri Hai Lee. Timothy Andrew Milosh. Nomi Hernandez Alexander.
That's okay, there's always time up for cheering. Yeah.
Amy Lynn Ivy Nankis. Evelyn Madden Nambasic, basic. Joseph Dietrich. Brian Jewett. Istvan Zambori. Will the faculty in economics and politics please be seated? And will the faculty in the Institute of Mathematical Sciences please come forward? Casey Lynn Johnson. Aisha Chen. Tuan Ming Dao. David Booth Kogan. Sean Cormett Matz. Hannah Mo Shahravirzi. Sylviana Monaco. Puya Sadikian. Ahmed Sayed Alfarez. Song Hong Duan. Will my colleagues in IMS please be seated? And will the faculty of the School of Educational Studies please come forward? Matthew Smith. Sammy Scales. Elizabeth Diana Kulo. David George Grant. Heidi J. Atkin.
Yeah, Heidi!
Danielle Frierson. Samara Ustina Sufoa. Eliud Partita. Timothy J. Hilton. Elizabeth Ashley Craig. Abdullah Alismail. Rhonda Williams. Michelle Deschanette. Catherine Casey Spengler. Yeah. Junalyn Pangan Peoples. This one I got. Alana Olschwang. Crystal McGill Rawls. Maria Stephanie Reyes. Rachel R. Camacho. Rocio Mendoza. Alonzo Campos. Jorge Alberto Lopez. Teddy Campos. Keisha Ann Goesby. Anthony V. Riel. Michelle Lynn Wise. Isabel Reyes.
Oh, congratulations.
Joel Lee Andrew Peterson. Erica Aros. Adelie Reyes Martinez. Latrice Deanne Bonner. Dustin Joel Tamashia. Shiro.
Thank you.
Borju Demiralp. Rocky E. Blessy Bragg. Quincy Penn. Christine Huang Quang. Shirley May Mommeriel Cho. Anaïs Janoyan. Susan Ward Roncalli. Fanny Cisneros. Freddie Sanchez. Sergio Mariano Pesquero. Patricia Perez Filamoa. Rachel Pittman. Will the faculty of the School of Educational Studies please be seated? And will the faculty in Arts and Humanities please come forward? Francesca Barroro Gaccio. Lauren K. Hartley. Jiang Xian Lin. Frank L. Stranaud. Justina Anna Misovich. Elizabeth Adekele. Clara Lee. Melissa F. Garula. David Nathaniel Isaacs. Shari Bisundat. Adrina Gregorian. Melanie Marie Lindsay. Liao. Amanda Lynn Pumphrey. Nawawiyah Umakar Muhammad. Travenna A. Hanna. Rachel Ostring. High Oak Park. Sarana Kaur Singh. Pablo Alvarez. Anthony Sean Blackshire. Seth I. Alt. Timothy Charles Malone. Rachel Adrian Hollenberg. Kin Ting Caleb Chung. Michael Warren Paces. Melissa Stacy Bishop Megalanis. God. Joseph Wayne Komrosky. Paul Ruder Pistone. Jeremiah R. Van Syk. Brian C. Bunker. Jeffrey Philip Munger. Mary Patricia Nolan Kaufman. Allison Lorraine Ernst. Meng Yu Jia. Robert William Mittendorf. Conrad Maurice Pruitt. We will recognize the recipients of the Master of Fine Arts degree. Will the faculty from the Art Department please step forward to hood your students? They're ready. Jill A. Stegall. Casey Joe Stegall. Shui Xu. Yu-Meng Young. Junan Jamal Abdelmuti. Akela Novella Bird Green. Zafara A. Ahmed. Andrea Muniv. Jessica R. Chanky. Angelica Benales. Lillian Margot Friedel. Yu-Meng Her. Joy Brenneman. Alicia Cheatham. Naveen Hyder. Michelle Imami. Holly Perez. Isabella Rose Hackerman. Marissa Nicole Reyes. Jonah Elijah. Thank you. Deborah Louise Karodic. Kathleen Ann Fox. Before we begin the conferral of individual master's degrees, we have some special recognitions to make. There are several recipients who could not be here in person today. They are joining us remotely, and it is our pleasure to recognize their achievement today. They will be on the screens around the tent. From the School of Arts and Humanities, with a PhD in Cultural Studies, Kelsey J. Picken. And from the School of Arts and Humanities, an MA in English, Amanda Noel Bishop. From the Division of Behavioral and Organizational Sciences, with an MS Evaluation and Applied Research, is Patricia Lunzel Gorse. From the Division of Behavioral and Organizational Sciences, with an MA in Psychology, is Hannah Wennell Grammer. And from the same division with an the MS in Evaluation and Applied Research is also Deborah Cadu Sirwada. From the Center for Information Systems and Technology, Fazel Kamar Massoud, with an MS in Information Systems and Technology. From the Drucker School of Management, Nureina Mardia Moed Asmadi, with an MA in Art Business and Fine Art. From the Drucker School of Management is Virginia Ying Chiang, with a PhD in Management. Please join me in congratulating them. One of our first master's degrees today is a posthumous degree. Earlier, we awarded an honorary doctorate posthumously to Marshall Vallelunga of our Center for Information Systems and Technology. He is also a recipient of a Master of Science in Information Systems and Technology. Accepting his degree will be Marshall's daughter, Diana. Diana, please come forward to receive your father's degree.
think we're ready. Humad Mohammed El-Khattabi.
Karen C. Snow.
Catherine Lugar.
Malia Nicole Hall.
Elizabeth Faye Allen.
Leslie Ann Bienenfeld.
Sitwe Fawn.
Eve Wang Thulin.
John Sevier.
Jordan Leon Tyler.
Amy Egan.
Haibo Yam.
Sasha Zucker.
Michael Munico.
Sylvia Gregory Labarta.
Timothy Stephen Cormier.
Stephanie Michelle Ramirez.
Andrew George Rodriguez.
William Ward Loggy.
Sama Ali Basit.
Leah Heather Nichols.
Thawatsarn Suk Thai.
Robert Perez.
Praveen Bob.
Megan Jung.
Miles von Herman.
William Christopher Smizek.
Kenneth A. Carmona.
Brittany Grace Bowery.
Jose Enrique Corrado.
Florencio Juan Palad Cabitain.
Yalan Wang.
Larissa Santos da Rocha Lourdes.
Jing Peng.
Rebecca Renee Donaldson.
Wei Sui.
Kaiten Biker.
Youngja Sun.
Layla Beal.
Yikai Wang.
Ayman Kennedy Sukar.
Shahad Aladal.
Traverius Apollo Tolier, Jr. Ilias Enciso.
Nemer Nair Al-Sulami.
Danielle Anais Garcias.
Avat Helail Al-Balabi.
Godfrey Sentkaba.
Sen- Alvaro Duran.
George Albert Hernandez.
Yan Alice Tuan.
Jessica Barragan.
Ian Penuela Cueldad.
Kyle Ryder McGrath.
Shervin Kelvin Thomas.
Heidi Jean Callum.
Michael Garcia.
Alicia Davis.
Cha-Ching Xie.
Jacqueline Scheib.
Jason Huang.
Christian Romo.
Samuel Arnulfo Malagon.
Alian Elizabeth Punike.
Madeline Brown.
Rafid Romi.
Donald J. Berry.
Jaime Raul Diaz Alvarez.
Michael Duvon Montoya.
Elizabeth Marie Poulsen.
James Jose Chapman.
Hinako Ire.
Jorge Eduardo Pena.
Alisa Reen.
Anthony Ashkar.
Eva Lee.
Carol Stone Carson.
Kimberly Joanne Goodwin.
Yvonne Farrow.
Matthew Jack Gold.
Congratulations.
Ikea Fletcher.
David Aaron Altman.
Julia Elvira Chavez.
William D. DePrez.
Madeline Brooke Duran.
Megan Grisby Miller.
Beth A. Hubbard.
Jasmine Clark.
Patrick Andrew Moore.
Stephanie Matias.
Esther Liliani Santosa.
Emily UD.
Laria Liu.
Taylor Lorraine Francis.
Moto Okawa.
Shanna Salvador.
Yeah. Natalie Ann Ramirez.
Jasmine Bell Navarez.
Sonia Yang.
Giselle Barboza.
Nana Ajua Danoa Frimpong.
Adeline Zamara Gutierrez.
Brian Coino.
Cereza Inez Manzo.
Jessica Nicole Thomas.
Amy Riel Arriaga.
Khadija Hakim.
Steve Flores.
Huajing Gao.
Margot Harrington Clifford.
Masaki Takeuchi.
Ruby Ramirez Murillo.
Mira Budraksh Patel.
Kimberly Megasi. Jenny Maroquin.
Abraham Estuardo Bram.
Giselle Darlene Diaz.
Amanda Hiraishi.
Lavana Bhattarathi Jarawathal.
Shams Ekram Lodi.
Melanie L. Kerr.
Shankar Chandrasekharan.
Crystal Ramirez. Colby Marie Rousseff.
Valerie May Alcantara.
Erin Angela Harris Terrell.
Eric Lee.
Yonisha Ortez.
Martin Abel Ancheta.
Elise Alejandra Theodizia Green.
Holden Thomas.
Michelle Galicia Cardenas.
Benjamin Douglas Kahn.
Elena Aron.
Haile Terune.
Naireda Guadalupe Montez.
Taylor Charles Bukeri.
Stephanie Nunez.
Kosuke Matsui.
Kia Vu.
Nur Ulaine Erfan.
Elizabeth Rodarte.
Mansoor Mohammed Al Malik.
Haley Karuki.
Karthik Purna.
Alana Corrine Williams.
Kriti Saxena.
Anthony Eingel.
Riba Sebastian Purakal.
I know they add my name
Alisa Marie Godina.
Thank you.
Regina Margie McConnell.
Brandy Nicole Peterson.
Carrie Herr.
Victoria Ann Espinoza.
Victoria Bausbach.
Joshua Timothy Jackson.
Chi Moa.
Idaim Robles.
Danielle Nicole Ricardo.
Enrique Robles.
Ria Satyavati.
Ashley Marie Elizondo.
Marilyn Corona.
Hanin Hamdala.
Ryan J. Warm.
Claudia Isabel Rodriguez.
Carson Joseph Bridges.
Linda Stephanie Soval.
Kurt M. Phillips.
Fatima Salah Jaffer.
Jason Patel.
Joseph Ezekiel Cazares.
Shivani Kakade. Jacqueline Corral.
Elijah Sebastian Falk.
Nicholas Christian Light.
Robin Samantha Orzoco.
Yumeng Chung.
Lauren Anna Marie Roberts.
Motaz Alhamidi Al-Anizi.
Shannon Harvey.
Soichiro Ito.
Miranda Eliza Miller.
Ping Zhang.
Naomi Megan Nemo.
Chin Liu.
Alaya Rebecca Khan.
Sirish Vinakota.
Yasmin Alexandra Perez.
Jung Su.
Therese Julia Chavez Ui.
Guangpeng Ren.
Claudia Vanessa Reyes.
Nicholas Eugene Lauer.
Natasha Alize Blaise.
Eunice Young Kim.
Rye Michael Finnerty.
Oscar Daniel Rodriguez Aguilar.
Siddharth Bakar.
Nicholas Mitchell Seminara.
Kimberly Star Cross.
Samantha Marie Quesada Diaz. Sean G. Matosian. Jessica Geiger. Christian Javier Cabunyag. Sumaya Faki. Jason Franco Justo.
Brianna Vaquez.
Emmanuel S. Dumaguing.
Naif Elamanamud.
Mark S. Smith.
Joel Guerrero.
Abdullah Saad Asuwaile.
Merit Tades Elialasi.
Fawaz Sudan Alotebi.
Jasmine Castillo.
Nicholas Beter.
Maricel Santos Moscoso.
Jing Jing An.
Erica Jiha Park.
Afra Ali Al Noaimi.
Okay, so what's your name? Xu Xian Chen.
Gawan Khalid Alotaim.
James Makoto Morimoto. Rachel Kochar.
Sahar Al-Kunaibit.
Sevra Ramachitahita.
Ibrahim Al-Sohibani.
Caleb Isaac Portales.
Anthony Bainey.
Brandon Law.
Vidyawan Chandra Yunyanto.
Leilani Santua Martinez.
Mohammed Ahmed Abd El Rahman Ahmed Kashba.
Sarah Winglertz.
Tammy Tayor Ari Kenby.
Catherine Sonia Tabakian.
Shin In B.
Carolyn Basil.
Gabriel Megan, Andrew Medina.
Megan Lee Fueling.
Kathleen Nicole Cruz.
Alexis Manzano.
Sierra Ruby Newby Smith.
Tan V. Reddy.
Amanda Jean Gallup.
Jennifer Lynn Legenwalter.
Leah Olson.
Hannah E. Peterson.
Leah Marie Dopp.
Gabrielle Jablonski.
Ashley Denise Wayne.
Sienna Louise Rapiti Schmidt.
Summer Block Leiser.
Marissa Ramirez.
Alexandra Marie Conrad.
Hazel Ann Velia Escuza.
Michelle Chavez.
Kaylee Barnes.
Tessa Lepore.
Tendai Quenzura.
Cindy Aragon.
Francis Joseph Asenga.
Gungju Cha. Catherine Ann Rutz Robbins.
Excellent.
Peter Rodriguez. Shanika Johnson. Tyler Andre Zimmerman. Courtney Lamb. Serena Elace Robinson. Latiara Monet Rashid. Michelle Brittany Romero. Chian Louise Yeo. Panta Razavian. Raquel Soleil Ballestera. Anime Cairns Sachs. Wendy Angiano. Abigail Caitlin Lawler. Anisha Ahuja. Josiah Samuel Solis.
I'm still mad at you, Josiah! I'm still mad at you!
Ellison Kaler. Monique Linnae McDaniel. Amanda Noah Bishop.
All right. Congratulations to all of our graduates. Well done. Okay, as our commencement ceremony winds down, we just have one more thing to do, and that's the important tradition to give the charge to this year's graduates. And our speaker this year to do that is the president of our Alumni Association Board, Zenobia Walji. Zenobia has an incredible worldview and a professional background, literally having traveled the world, working across six continents. A few years ago, she decided to return to Southern California from Asia, and she wanted to reconnect with her life back in this region and with our Alumni Association. And the association was a great help to her, and now she is the leader of our Alumni Association. She's here today to offer you the charge as we end the commencement ceremony, so please join me with a warm welcome for Zenobia Walji.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Len. Well, it's quite appropriate the last step in graduation is that you become officially a member of the Alumni Association. So to share a very short story, recognizing that I'm standing between you and celebrating today, not long ago I had to make a very big decision, and that was after crossing 30 years in healthcare and 17 years in Asia, I decided to come back stateside. Having been outside the US for so long, I knew I was going to feel disoriented and disconnected. And I'm sure many of you who've crossed geographies that you felt this way before. I was looking for an anchor, a place where I could feel grounded again. And I chose Southern California because I had gone to school here, both to CMC and CGU. I felt I could come back to Southern California to leverage my work in healthcare so that I could shape a future from here. And that meant a lot that I could come back. So something interesting happened at the time that I came back, and that is that CGU had just created an Alumni Association Board. This was the first time in 90 years that our school had established a cross-school alumni board. That meant a lot to me, and I hope that it will mean a lot to you too. You've created ties here at CGU, and even if you couldn't be on campus much, and even if you had to squeeze studies between the demands of your daily life, it's time to enjoy the rewards of that hard work, one of which is being part of a global alumni community. So before this ceremony comes to an end, I wanted to share three nuggets that I hope will serve you well. The first is to leverage the full power of your networks. You have access to tremendous knowledge and experience, and the CGU alumni represent a network of friends and traveling partners in your journey of life. As alumni president, I encourage you to tap us to broaden your connections. Not just for you, but also for future generations of alumni. Second, go out there and make contributions to the communities in which you live and work. I learned this from the late Peter Drucker, who had a very profound impact on me. He believed it was important to take your sense of ethics and values and use it to serve your communities. And you can do this in many ways. Just look for something your community needs and use your special gifts. Giving back really grounds you. Lastly, remember that connections you have built here at CGU can help you in many aspects of life, both personal and professional. Connections you've made here are lifelong, and if you don't feel you've made enough connections, don't worry. That's what our Alumni Association is for. The association is an avenue for making connections both within and across schools. and it's never too late to start, and I can attest for that. I discovered that when I returned 3 years ago, and I had been gone for 30. Today, you're on time. When you first started at CGU, you might remember getting pinned by your fellow students. And today, you'll receive another pin. So after the ceremony, please stop by the Alumni Association table for your pin and other materials that we've assembled for you. Graduates, you've come full circle today. Today, you're joining our 23,000 strong alumni community. And I would say, looking at all of you out there, if we round up, we're probably at 24,000 alumni. So congratulations. Woo! On behalf of the Alumni Association, we're very, very proud of you, and we're excited for you. We look forward to becoming traveling partners and to supporting your success. So go out there, conquer, enjoy, and best wishes. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Zenobia, for closing us out. It's been so great working with you on the Alumni Association Board. Quickly, will the banner carriers from each school please make their way forward to retrieve your school's banners? And to the members of the classes of 2022, 2021, and 2020, I just want you to remember something important, that your involvement with CGU doesn't end with commencement. As Zenobia's story shows, graduation marks the start of a new chapter, and you'll always be a part of our CGU community and family. We invite you to join us all with the CGU Alumni Association in building a great university that makes the world a better place through incredible research, teaching, and highly impactful practice. The symbol of the university is the flame. We've referenced it several times today, and we wish you much success in carrying the flame forward into the next stage in your life. Before some final instructions about exiting, just wanted to say thank you to all of our staff who helped put things on today. We've got live music in the back. Donna and Gerard and Mary and a number of people. We've got a commencement committee that works on this. And oh, I see my wife with flowers. Are those for me? Would you bring those up? Oh, wait, my wife says they're not for me. I wanted to say a special thank you, not only to the entire commencement committee, but our own Cindy Bierman, who's been the point person for commencement for like 2 months. Cindy, come on up. Thank you. Thank you for indulging. Thank you, Cindy. You are cordially invited to participate in the receptions provided for all of our graduates and their guests, and they'll be held at the various schools, and the locations are listed in the commencement program, and they're all around us. Now, this is the important part. Please keep the aisles clear so the graduates may exit and meet you at their respective school reception. And I'd like to ask our graduates, just wait until the program party exits. Let us get through, then the students will get through, and then we'll all go on to the receptions. Thank you so much for attending. It is my pleasure to announce that the 95th annual commencement of Claremont Graduate University is now officially closed. Thank you.